and welcome to this edition of Salima Speaks. Well, most of you know that I have a new show coming out called, well, it was called The Real Cougars of Philadelphia. It's now called The Ultimate Cougar, me. And I date younger men, normally men under 40, for a certain reason. Because I don't know what happens to men when they turn 40. I'm serious, something happens. But I just found out the other day, I should have known this, there is this thing called andropause. Haha. Menopause for men. Look it up. Now check this out. It's a chemical imbalance. These doctors got together because they've too found out men are going nutty after 38, going into 40, and is a chemical imbalance that they have. So I was right. Something is wrong with men over 40. Okay. So that's why I don't normally date them. I don't know what it is. Maybe their little thingy doesn't get hard anymore and they go crazy or whatever. But I'm serious. It's something going on there. But now with this new andropause thing, I really think that we're onto something. There's medication they can take. They change their diet, they exercise. So there are cures for it, but it is real. It's a real illness. So I wasn't wrong. It's something wrong with them, okay? So anyway, look it up. And if you have a man over 40, he's going a little bit psycho, he might have the andropause, you know? And there's a cure for it. But I think that my thing is we're all crazy, some crazier than others, okay? But this andropause thing is real and is affecting a lot of men. Because you notice a lot of men over 40, they leave their families or they cheat on the wife for younger women or they change sex. But we'll talk about that when we get back. See you when you get back. I have a great show for you. Hello and welcome back. Like I said, this is a very interesting show. I have my friend Victoria Miller. Hello, Victoria.
Hello.
And my friend Shati Knox.
How are you doing?
And we're going to talk about the elephant in the room. No, not me, because I did lose weight. But we're talking about my friend Victoria here. And Victoria is a transgender.
Yes, I am a transgendered
female. And tell me about that.
Well, I recognized this at age 6. I came home from kindergarten and told my mother that I wanted to wear dresses and play with dolls.
At age 6?
Yeah, it didn't go over well.
Okay.
You know, of course, I was scolded, and then you learn quickly that don't bring that subject up again.
Okay, let me ask you this, because we talked about the transgender. There's so many things. There's transsexual, transgender, bi, this, that. What the hell are you?
Well,
are you gay? Are you this? Tell me what you are.
Well, there's a little disparity in terms.
Okay.
Our community, I mean, I'm really called a transsexual.
Okay.
You know, I was born male and anatomically male.
Okay.
And I am going through transition with hormones, various surgeries, and when they're done, I'll be a female.
Okay. Various surgeries. So you're going to get your weenie cut off, for lack of better term.
It's not really cut off. It's kind of more like inverted.
All right, let me ask you this. All right, for real. I always wondered this. Now, I'm going to ask you, it's personal, but did you have a big one or a little one? You know, and
I would say average.
Average, because you know, I was thinking that maybe some guys that have a little weenie, maybe they that's part of the sexuality, and if it's little, a woman doesn't want to be involved with them. So,
well, I mean, I can tell you it's documented. It works because I have 2 children. So
okay, and they're your children.
Yes, they're my children.
Oh man, so all right, let me so. You were? All right, so age six, you came home in a dress. That didn't go over well. So did you leave it dormant, the woman
thing?
Well,
yeah, you hide your desires. Every time my mom and dad would go out as I got older, I would go raid my mom's closet and dress up in her clothes.
Get out of here.
Yeah, and then she would find, like, you know, whatever heels left in the middle of her room. Like, how did this get here?
So you were running change when they would come in.
Oh, yeah. And a couple of times I got caught. And, of course, you get scalded. And then at 17, my dad found my stash of girls' clothes.
Oh, wow.
And, of course, I lied and said that they were my girlfriends. She left them here. And then I had to
make... So you did have a girlfriend?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I had a longtime girlfriend, Kathy, for over 20 years.
Wow.
From my junior year in high school all the way out.
But that's not who you married.
No, okay. No. I actually split up with her because, I loved her very much. She we're still friends today.
Oh, okay.
She's
I'd
an incredible woman.
But she's
I mean, we were engaged the whole nine yards, but okay. I really kind of, I realized that I wanted to do this and I didn't want to kind of screw up her life.
Okay. So you were with her, but were you seeing men on the side?
No. Our sexual preference in my community, sometimes some transgendered women they'll be attracted to women their whole lives.
Okay.
And they stay that way after transition. Some of us, our preferences change. Some of us are bi. So it's no different than the straight or the gay community.
Okay, so you wouldn't consider yourself as gay, but you do prefer men.
Now I prefer men, yes.
Okay, so at one time, then when you were with your wife, you were bi?
No, I didn't. It wasn't really until after I was on hormones for about 2 years that...
Why would anybody want to be a woman? I mean, I like it, but we go through so much, men. So you're taking hormones so you'd be more like a woman, crying and bitching and all that crazy. Can't handle period.
Yeah,
though,
yeah, going through puberty at 55 is not a barrel of laughs. I can tell you that.
Okay, so you heard me talk about andropause, and that's not you. You don't have andropause. You always thought that.
No.
Because you see, my thing is, check this out, for real. You know, if you get your penis inverted, we say we want to say on Salima Speaks. Suppose 5 years down the line, you said, damn, I really want to be a man. Now you don't,
This is not one of them decisions where you say,
I really didn't want that. Where's my weenie? I don't have it no more.
Well, when you do this, you have to go through, you have to deal with a therapist.
Okay.
And a therapist basically has to clear you for surgery. So you have to, go through what they call the real life test.
Okay.
Which that means living, working, and existing as a woman for a year. And then after that, and several counseling sessions, then if she feels or he or she feels that, this is what you really want and really need, then they'll clear you for surgery.
Okay, now, it's so many questions. I want to get you in on this in a minute. But so you were married and you do have children.
Yes.
And your children are 11 and 17?
12 and 16.
12 and 16, mm-hmm. Okay. Now, your 16-year-old, last year she had a dad.
Yeah.
So what is she going through now?
Well, it's really hard. 3 years ago, I started a very contentious divorce. I actually left my wife for another reason. It had nothing to do with this. She actually knew about this side of me before we got married.
Really?
17 years ago, yeah. She was actually an employee at my business.
Okay.
17 years ago.
Okay.
And what she was doing was assembling transgendered books that I would print for a publisher.
Okay.
And, she actually made a joke. She said, you'd look cute in a dress, and I pointed to my picture in the book, and I said, yes, I do, don't I? and she didn't believe it was me, and then we started dating after that. So,
okay, so she knew?
Yeah, but I mean, in all fairness, I thought of myself back then as a cross-dresser. It really wasn't until my father's death, and my father and mother died in 2000, that it really hit me, a realization hit me at
their
funeral.
They both died at the same time?
Within 6 months of each other,
yes. Are you serious? Wow.
Yeah, they both died from lung cancer. It was very painful. Mm-hmm. And I realized that at my father's funeral, who died last, that my life was spent making sure other people were proud of me and
for
other people.
All of us.
Yeah, but it was I was doing everything for everybody else but
okay.
me.
Okay.
I literally worked myself into the dirt, and when the economy collapsed in 2000, I was so stressed out I contracted diabetes.
Wow.
In 2013, I was hospitalized due to diabetic paresis and lost over 40 pounds in
Well, how can I get some
weeks.
Of that? That's
yeah. Believe me, it's not fun.
Oh, wow.
It's worse than the anorexics and bulimics go through, so it's a pretty nasty thing. I went down to 134 pounds in 4 weeks, which
wow.
was very nasty. And I'm working myself back being healthy, but mental health is just as important as physical health.
And see, some people would say that you're kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Your mental health, isn't stable because
A good friend of mine who's very, very religious made a statement to me. He said, God doesn't make mistakes.
Okay.
And he disagrees with what I'm doing to myself. And I said, you're right. God doesn't make mistakes. And he looked at me kind of puzzled, and I said, well, as a man, you have an X and a Y chromosome, and your wife has two X chromosomes. I have XXY. So I was born with an extra female chromosome, or they call it Klinefelter syndrome. And there's a fair amount of transgender people, not all, but there's a fair amount of transgender people that have that same condition.
I have a high level of testosterone. My whole family, the women do, but I love me some men.
It really kind of took me by surprise. I mean, I would look at a guy and say, well, he's a good looking guy. And then it became, wow, he's a pretty good looking guy. And then it came, wow, he's a good looking guy.
Okay.
So it's interesting how that comes about. And it happened at a transgender conference. A gentleman asked me to dance. So I danced when it was a fast dance.
Okay.
And then when a slow dance came, I thought I was just going to get off the floor, but I felt these two big arms just grab me and pull me in. And when he did, it felt right.
Really?
Like I felt like, okay, it was like coming home. Like you feel like I belong there.
Okay.
This is the way I feel. And at the end of the dance, he kissed me, and then I really felt right. So it was really a... one of those aha moments that this is right. This is what I'm supposed to be.
Wow. Let's bring in Mr. Knox over here. Do you have any questions for Miss Victoria? Well, see, you know what? And I have to be honest with you. People have been getting on me all week, and I really don't give a damn because this is my show. I have a problem calling you a woman. I do.
Yeah, it's funny. Some people will that know me will sometimes address me as he, and that's only because they knew me for 55 years as a guy. It happens more so when I'm talking to them on the phone because they hear my guy voice.
Yeah, because when you called me the other
day,
you're like, who? I was like, I don't know you.
Right, exactly. But when I'm talking to them face to face, they see Vicky and they're used to that.
But do you have a problem with that?
When you go through this process, if you're that kind of person that's going to get upset if somebody calls you sir, or somebody's going to recognize you or make a comment in a store, you're going to have a difficult time.
Right.
Unless you're, 112 pounds and totally passable and you did this at age 17,
right.
You have to have a little bit of a thick skin.
Yeah, because my thing is you were born a man, so I'm going to say man, sir, hello, mister.
Exactly. I've had people... call me sir, and I correct them.
Okay.
And I'll say I prefer ma'am.
Right. What I'm saying is you don't just go all, because I had somebody that really kind of went off because, let me tell you something. I'm not going to apologize for being straight, okay? I'm not going to hurt you for what you believe in, but I'm not going to jump over myself and beat myself up because I'm straight.
If I'm having a conversation with somebody and I correct them once and twice and three times and they keep going, then I'm going to start to get a little bit upset because I think they're doing it purposely and disrespectful.
Right.
I had a operator do that to me one day on the phone, and they asked me, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to? And I tell them my name is Victoria, and they're... their recite my name back to me, and then he calls me sir, and I said, well, it's ma'am.
Well, I've gotten called sir on the phone also. You know, because I have kind of a deep voice.
After about the fifth time, you start to get a little bit annoyed about it. But in general, no, we don't. In fact, there's actually a directive in Philadelphia now for the Philadelphia Police Department. It's called Directive 152. And that's that the police officers have to address us correctly according to our credentials, yes.
Okay. So, all right, so you jump on in.
I do have a question.
Sure. Earlier, speak up.
Yes, earlier you mentioned that, you know, you used to hide your feelings, you know, mm-hmm. the identity confusion, you know, with your parents or whatever. Mm-hmm. At what point in time did you stop being ashamed and just...
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, before I, like, told the world and came out, that was a little over a year ago, and I did it.
Oh, so this is all very new.
Yes, okay. I sent out 1,000 emails, and I took my Facebook page name down. I took Robert down and put Victoria up,
wow.
and put my picture up, and
wow.
an explanation as to what I am and what's going to go on. And I put, if you didn't like me, there's always the unfriend button. And I put all my emails that I sent out. If you don't want to hear from me again, just return an email with the word remove. I had one email returned, and I went from 92 friends to 155 in about a week and a half.
Wow.
And then I went to my 35th high school reunion, which was a real barrel of laughs. But
so you went as Victoria?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. And wow. my friend Lisa, when she asked me if I was going to go, I said no. She says, I'm going to drag you if you don't go. So she says, I'm coming to your house. I'm going to pick you up, and I'm taking you. And we went.
Speaking of drag, because like I'm seeing all these terms and everything, so you wouldn't be considered a drag queen.
No, a drag queen is somebody who's like campy and a performer, and they don't live their life as a woman.
Oh, okay.
You know, when we do this, I never, you know, I have never reverted back to a guy. I mean, obviously, it's going to be kind of hard to hide certain things now.
But at one time, you did enjoy sex with women.
Well, yeah. But like
I
said...
Well, I should want to answer the question. Did you enjoy sex with women?
Well, kind of yeah, kind of no. But yeah, no, I mean...
It's like a
yeah,
second leave.
I mean, like I said, you know, it's documented. It happened twice since I have two kids. But no, it's you know, your preferences change sometimes.
Okay.
So, you know, it's all kind of a new world to me, and it's new... You know, I'm basically
getting about yourself?
Real good. Well, I'm getting a good education right now on knowing that most men are pigs, but
you know,
but yeah. But no, it's just a big education, and you find that people, I found out really how kind people are.
Really?
Yeah, I was expecting a whole lot of hate.
Mm. Okay.
I was expecting, you know. My one friend said, yeah, don't expect, you know, you may get drug around by a pickup truck like they used to do to people down south. And I'm like, no, I don't think, you know, we live in...
Well, they actually didn't do it to transgender people.
Yeah.
They did it to people with chocolate skin.
Yeah, but...
Well, I know what you're saying.
No, I mean, there was very little negativity.
Really?
Yeah.
And let me let you in on this, because I know you're coming from a spiritual point of view.
Yes.
So you can... Jump one in
yeah,
there.
I want to ask him one more question before I speak on certain topics.
Okay.
You know, obviously your children were birthed through, you know, you being a man, your mm-hmm. manhood. How do you want them to view you now as father or mother?
Well, I mean, they already have a mother. I don't want to take away from or remotely try to say I'm their mother, because mother to me describes birth, mm-hmm. you know, and that's their mother. You know, going through a very contentious divorce for the last 3 years, my wife has actually blocked me from talking to my children, even in multiple court mm-hmm. orders and things. Mm-hmm. When that time comes and we start conversing more, I mean, I came out to them, and it was kind of a shock to them. But when we do start going through this again, I'm going to really let them choose. I mean, I kind of came up with a solution. In my wife is Hungarian, and in the Hungarian culture, mother is Anyu, father is Apu.
Mm.
So they could call me Apu, because nobody would know what Apu means
So you don't want them to run up to you and say, Daddy, Daddy.
Well, I mean, that doesn't matter to me.
Okay.
If they want to still call me Dad, they can just call me Dad. If they want to call me Aunt Vicky, they could call me that. It's more to me, it's not about hurting my feelings. It's what would help them be more comfortable.
You know, Vicky, I just, you know, your children, I can understand at 16, they're already going through crazy stuff, body image on their own. Mm-hmm. But then to, you know, last year I had a dad, and now it's like I have a who knows what, you know?
Well, so. it is tough on kids. I have had several of my friends do exactly what I'm doing.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
You know, my friend Kalina did it. My friend Jen did it.
Are you serious?
And, wow. Yeah, and Jen's son, you know, said, still calls Jen Dad.
Okay.
And said, Dad, I want you to, you know, come to Cub Scouts with me. So, and Jen was very excited
well,
about
we
that.
Well, maybe I'll have some more of your friends. Y'all can't get in here and beat me up, though, because it's my show.
Yeah.
But I might have some of your friends to come on. But let me, as far as your wife is concerned, you were saying it was a messy divorce. She knew.
Well, yeah, she knew.
So what does she think? What does she think she knew going to change?
Well, there's some women that are, they call them, they're like, they think they're fixers. They can fix somebody who's broken.
Mm.
Or they could, you know, my wife was fine with this. She actually used to clothes shop for me and buy me jewelry and
wow.
things like that
okay.
until my children came. And
okay.
then once my children came, her disposition towards
so all of a sudden you're supposed to go from liking to dress like women to being
right.
Mr. Man.
And
wow.
and then it was, I would go to a transgendered event once a month.
Okay.
That was like my time. And then it became, oh, we're busy, so you can't go this month. And then it just started fueling a real big situation. And
okay.
Yeah.
And you know when I met you, I thank you for being so open because they know that I ask the questions that everybody wants to know. We're afraid to ask. I ask them. But when I first saw you, you said that you realized that you when people see you, they see a man. But I've seen women that look more manly than you.
Well, I mean, people come in all different shapes and sizes. I mean, my one cousin, Janice, is a little bit taller than me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she's very pretty, but I've seen women that are taller than me, women that are, you know.
Oh, you would tell that the funny story you're saying that you were in traffic and the guy was blowing.
Yeah, I mean, see, when you go through this, you know, the hormonal changes are kind of a barrel of laughs. The only way I can describe it is it's kind of like if you're Anakin Skywalker and Darth Vader, you know, good versus evil is battling you inside.
Okay.
And certain things will trigger certain behaviors.
Right.
If I see the little SPCA commercial with the sad puppy dogs, sometimes I'll cry.
Okay.
And there was a gentleman who we had a situation in traffic, and he was clearly in the wrong, and he starts rolling down his window and screaming and yelling. And at first I was sitting there, okay, Vicky, you got to be a good little girl. You can't say anything. You can't curse, until he got really, really nasty. And then when he got really, really nasty and started saying some really nasty comments, then...
Now, was he saying nasty comments because he knew that you were...
Well, that I don't know.
Okay.
And then I was in front of an open air cafe.
Oh, you say he called you that C word?
Yeah, he called me a dumb C word.
Okay.
And
cut. White right, women hate bitch, like we hate bitch, I guess.
Right. Well, and as soon as he said that, you know, I call it Bob reared his ugly head, and Bob popped out and got out and started yelling at him and say, well, why don't you get out of your car and all these people here can watch a transsexual kick your ass. And he just go like, oh my God, he rolled up the window and he drove away and all the people were clapping like, huh, you really scared the hell out of him. But, you know, it just, what's funny, the emotional thing and how you react changes.
Okay.
As a guy, I was a pretty aggressive kind of guy.
Really?
As Vicky, I'm more passive.
Okay.
But at that time frame when that happened, I wasn't that long into hormones. Now, I've had people do some pretty nasty things.
Okay.
And I don't get upset now. I kind of almost chuckle at it. Like, really, you're getting that upset over this? Like, you're pretty funny.
Wow.
But yeah,
and you were saying because I saw you as a man, you were all right, but you weren't no Brock Hudson. You know, but you,
I mean. A couple of friends say I look like Mr. Magoo, but that's.
Kind of, sort of, yeah, but you know, but you, you don't look anything like that picture. We're going to, you know, show that picture. But,
You dreaded before.
And you were saying that as a man, you didn't, like, some men do primp, straight men do primp and look like men and stuff. And as a man, you weren't that concerned about.
My idea of primping when I was a guy was dragging a comb through my hair.
And, wow.
And putting a hat on, that was it.
I mean, now you're in the mirror doing eyes.
I'm sometimes I can spend 2.5 hours doing hair and makeup, yeah.
And you enjoy that?
Very much so. Very, wow. Very much so. Wow. It's, you know, it's almost like a ritual. You know, just seeing how I can make myself look and, you know, different things like that.
And we have we're running a little out of time, but do you have anything else? This show could go on because it's really interesting.
Yeah, I would like to say that, as you know, a Christian, you know, I know what I know about, you know, how God creates people. And, you know, I think God creates everybody the way they are. I'm not nobody to come on here and judge for another person's way of life or decision they made in life. But, you know, he or she, you know, made a comfortable, kind of uncomfortable, you know, decision in life.
Right.
She's comfortable with it. At the same time, other people might not be. So,
Let me ask you, do you believe in God?
Yes, I do. Very, very much so. I was baptized a Catholic.
Okay. You still go as a Catholic?
Well, no, I don't go to a Catholic church because the Catholic church is not all too...
Oh, they'll probably burn you or something.
Yeah, they're
tie you to a cross, you know, or something.
Yeah, right. They're not too keen on us.
You're what?
I currently go to a Methodist church.
Okay. And they're more accepting?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, they're you know, they're 100% more accepting. You know, they accept everybody from the LGBT community.
So you weren't like mad at God, kind of, you know, I'm supposed to be a woman.
I believe,
made a mistake.
No. I mean, we were, I look at this as I was born this way for a reason. I had one friend ask me if I thought I was cursed to have to go through this.
Right.
And I say, no, I was actually blessed because now I've done some talks in front of transgender youth groups.
Really?
And just getting... helping other people. I mean, this is a tough thing to do.
Oh, I'm so sure.
There's a 35% suicide rate.
Really?
In transgendered people. And there's a lot of us out there. There's 46,000 of us in Philadelphia alone.
All right, I would rather have you than have a down low man, okay? At least you know what you want to be.
Right.
They don't, anyway.
Right.
But
yeah, what I was saying
we really have to close now. I'm so sorry. We're going to maybe have to come back with this because it's such an interesting topic. Thank you so much, Ms. Vicky.
Thank you.
And thank you.
No problem. Thank you very much for being.
Thank you for seeing this interesting show. I mean, we have to come back and have Ms. Vicky and some of his friends back on. Y'all can't beat me up, like I said, to talk about this because it's very interesting. Okay. Yes. So anyway, thank you guys. And remember, love yourself, love others, and don't forget to stretch. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.